إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. الله سبحانه وتعالى mentioned many stories in the Quran to gain the benefits from them, not only to enjoy the time. They are true stories. And these stories from the prophets, from the righteous people, and sometimes about bad people, to avoid their way. One of the examples Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, or one of the stories Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, Talut and Jalut, this battle. At the beginning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الْمَلَإِ مِنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مُوسَى إِذْ قَالُوا لِنَبِيٍّ لَهُمْ مُبْعَثْ لَنَا مَلِكًا نُقَاتِلْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Have you not considered the assembly of the children of Israel after the time of Musa, when they said to a prophet of theirs, what is the name of that prophet? It is not mentioned. It is not important that your name is known among people, but Allah knows your name, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do we know the name of this prophet? We don't know. Allah mentioned that? He did not mention. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned his name? No. But still, he is a prophet. He is an important man, alayhi salatu wasalam. So don't worry if people don't know your name. Allah knows what you are doing. Allah knows your deeds, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Send to us a king. Ib'ath lana malikan. Send to us a king, and we will fight in the way of Allah, fi sabilillah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or that prophet, said to them, قَالَ هَلْ عَسَيْتُمْ إِن كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْقِتَالُ أَلَّا تُقَاتِلُوا. The Prophet answered them, would you perhaps refrain from fighting if a battle was prescribed for you? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تتمنوا لقاء العدو وإذا لقيتموهم فاصبروا. Don't wish to fight your enemy. But if the battle comes to you, if fighting comes to you, the enemy attacks you, you have to be patient. But wishing, fighting the enemy, this is not the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قال هل عسيتم إن كتب عليكم القتال ألا تقاتلوا. Then they said, وما لنا ألا نقاتل وما لنا ألا نقاتل في سبيل الله وقد أخرجنا من ديارنا وأبنائنا. فلما كتب عليهم القتال تولوا إلا قليلا منهم والله عليم بالظالمين. سبحان الله. The Prophet said to them, would you perhaps refrain from fighting in battle if battle was prescribed for you? They said, and why should we not fight in the cause of Allah when we have been driven out from our homes and from our children? We are oppressed. But this is not easy. To fight You see people are killed in front of you. Then if you flee from the battlefield, this is a major sin in Islam. التولي من الزحم الكبائر الذنوب. Then what happened? But when battle was prescribed for them, Allah gave them the order to fight. They turned away. Subhanallah. They asked for fighting and they turned away. Except for few of them. And Allah is knowing of the wrongdoers. Subhanallah. Don't ask something difficult. If you are in ease, accept that. Alhamdulillah, Allah will reward you. Do what you have ordered to do. Allah will reward you for that. So Allah gave them the order. They have to go forward. وَقَالَ لَهُمْ نَبِيُّهُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ بَعَثَ لَكُمْ طَالُوتَ مَلِكًا قَالُوا أَنَّ يَكُونُ لَهُ الْمُلْكُ عَلَيْنَا وَنَحْنُ أَحَقُّ بِالْمُلْكِ مِنْهُ وَلَمْ يُؤْتَ سَعَةً مِنَ الْمَالِ. And their prophet said to them, again, their prophet, what is the name? We don't know. Their prophet said to them, indeed Allah has sent to you Talut as a king. They said, how can he have kingship over us while we were more worthy of kingship than him? And he has not been given any measure of wealth. Subhanallah. This is the wrong concept. The leader should be a wealthy man, well-known man. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them, informed his prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to tell them that Talut is your leader. Because he can lead the army. Not because of his name, his family name, his tribe. Allah chose him for you. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاللَّهُ يُؤْتِي مُلْكَهُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Then this prophet, sorry, said to them, قَالَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَاهُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَزَادَهُ بَسْطَةً فِي الْعِلْمِ وَالْجِسْمِ وَاللَّهُ يُؤْتِي مُلْكَهُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ. Indeed, Allah has chosen him over you and has increased him abundantly in knowledge and stature. This is enough for fighting. His body is strong. He has knowledge. This is enough to fight and to lead the army. And Allah gives his kingdom. Allah gives his sustenance, his provision to whom he wills. And Allah is all encompassing in favor and knowing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. And people don't know. As he said subhanahu wa ta'ala in another ayah, وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. And you know, and Allah knows, and you don't know. The full knowledge, the great knowledge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but our knowledge is very little, nothing, if you compare it with the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقَالَ لَهُمْ نَبِيُّهُمْ. I will bring you a proof for that. وَقَالَ لَهُمْ نَبِيُّهُمْ إِنَّ آيَةَ مُلْكِي أَنْ يَأْتِيَكُمُ التَّابُوتِ فِي سَكِينَةٌ مِّنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَبَقِيَّةٌ مِّمَّا تَرَكَ آلُ مُوسَى وَآلُ هَارُونَ تَحْمِلُهُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَةً لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. He is their prophet. But also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala supported him with a proof. And their prophet said to them, indeed, a sign of his kingship is that the chest will come, the wooden box will come to you, and which is assurance from your Lord, and the remnant of what the family of Musa and the family of Harun had left. What exactly? Not mentioned. Allahu a'lam. Is it the Torah? Is it the stick of Musa? Allahu a'lam. And it is not important if it is not mentioned specifically in the Quran. Carried by the angels, indeed, in that is a sign for you if you are believers. We as human beings, we need these signs to strengthen our faith. It is enough when the Prophet says something. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us more proofs. To get what? Al-yaqeen, more yaqeen, certainty. Then they started to go for fighting. Khalas, it is an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Talut, he is unknown, but he was strong, knowledgeable, he is the leader. So at the beginning, most of them did not accept that, did not join the army. فَلَمَّا فَصَلَ طَالُوتُ بِالْجُنُودِ قَالَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مُبْتَلِيكُمْ بِنَهَرٍ. And when Talut went forth with the soldiers, he said, indeed, Allah will be testing you with a river. Allahu Akbar. Test after another test. This is life, brothers. Brothers, sisters, this is life full of tests. A test with your body. A test with your wife or husband, son, daughter, your job, money. This is life full of tests. Don't think that you live your life, the whole of your life, without any test, without any calamity. You should be ready for any calamity. How? Faith, iman, patience from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده وعلى آله وأصحابه أما بعد. الله سبحانه وتعالى سيد فلما فصل طالوت بالجنود قال إن الله مبتليكم بنهر. There is a test. What kind of test? Very tough. If your test, if your calamity is strong, this is according to your iman. Who are the most people or the most difficult test for the prophets alayhim salatu wasalam? Because they are in the higher rank in paradise. But of course we need to be patient, and we should not ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for any calamity. We should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be free from the calamities. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to worship Him peacefully until we enter paradise. قَالَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مُبْتَلِيكُمْ بِنَهَرٍ فَمَنْ شَرِبَ مِنْهِ فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي فَمَنْ شَرِبَ مِنْهِ فَلَيْسَ مِنِّي وَمَنْ لَمْ يَطْعَمْهُ فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي إِلَى مَنْ اغْتَرَفَ غُرْفَةً بِيَدِهِ. So, whoever drinks from it is not of me. And whoever doesn't taste it is indeed of me. Excepting one who takes from it in the hollow of his hand. Subhanallah. We are going to fight. We are not allowed to drink from this river. You are allowed to drink from it. But if you drink from this river, don't join this army. Because I need the strong people. Weak people, no need for them with the army. The weak people will make the army weaker. No need for them. Don't be sad if you lose some of your friends from your da'wah. Why? Because sometimes they make your da'wah weaker. They are lazy. They are weak. We don't need them. But there is an exception. It is allowed to drink very little water. What is needed for you. But with your hand. إِلَّا مَنْ اخْتَرَفَ غُرْفَةً بِيَدِهِ. What happened after that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَشَرِبُوا مِنْهِ. Subhanallah. فَشَرِبُوا مِنْهِ. إلا قليلا منهم سبحان الله. But they drank from it except a very few of them. From the beginning, when the Prophet declared the jihad, most of them turned away.
So he has now very small number. And from this very small number, most of them failed the test. And they drank from the water. Subhanallah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that the number of soldiers who was fighting with the king Talut was like the number of the companions who were with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the battle of Badr. 319. Allah gave them the victory. And they were very little number. So the victory, not because of your number, because of your power, because of your helpers, because of your name, because of your wealth. وَمَن نَصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. The victory, it is only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are weak because we trust people. And we forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَشَرِبُوا مِنْهِ إلا قليلا منهم فلما جاوزه والذين آمنوا معه قالوا لا طاقة لنا اليوم بجالوت وجنوده قال الذين يظنون أنهم ملاقوا الله كم من فئة قليلة غلبت فئة كثيرة بإذن الله والله مع الصابرين. سبحان الله. But they drank from it except a very few of them. Then when he had crossed it along with those who believed with him, they said, there is no power for us today against Jalut and his soldiers. But those who were certain that they would meet Allah said, how many a small company has overcome a large company by permission of Allah, and Allah is with the patient. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among the patient. Inshallah, we'll continue next week. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب ومجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان. اجعلنا اللهم من الراشدين. اللهم عنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم عنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم عنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم اسقنا الغيث ولا تجعلنا من القانطين. اللهم اسقنا الغيث ولا تجعلنا من القانطين. اللهم اسقنا الغيث ولا تجعلنا من القانطين. اللهم اغثنا. اللهم اغثنا. اللهم اغثنا. اللهم انزل علينا رحماتك يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارسل علينا المطر مدرارا واجعله رحمة لنا لا عذاب يا رب العالمين. رحماك رحماك بالأطفال الرضع والعجائز الركع والنساء الأيام والأطفال اليتامى. اللهم لا تؤاخذنا بما فعل السفهاء منا. اللهم اسقنا الغيث ولا تجعلنا من القانطين. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.